Hello, YouTube, and welcome. This video is going to be about my opinions and thoughts, and also my ideas about Star Trek Online. What's good about it and what's bad about it, my original impressions on it when I first saw it, to right now. I'm sorry it's not going to have any gameplay footage. I'm probably going to do other videos on that later on, but let me tell you a little bit about this of how I feel right now as a first-time player. Okay, I've known about the game before alpha testing, when the first information came out about this project as it was being built. I thought, it's a pretty good idea, but will it work? There was other game projects that were starting around the same time, some were before, and it got to me to the point where, is this going to be like what they did with Star Wars when it first came out? Star Wars Online, the original one, where that one was good because you had a blank character and it allowed you to model your character the way you want. There was no particular class. You created the classes, or you found ways of getting certain types of classes or whatever. And it was very exciting when you actually became a Jedi or a Sith Lord or something. You know, you became a Force user, really, if you want to say that. Until they changed it to where being a Jedi was now a class. And then it lost all of its magic and charm on that. But for people that just wanted to be a Jedi without really working, I guess it worked for them. But I like how it was originally. Even though there was a little, you know, quirkiness to it, you know, there was bugs, but I liked it for the way it was. I expect that games should go in that way. If you're going to do a Star Wars game or Star Trek game, that's actually a good idea. Yeah, but this game in particular, it's something like that, but a little bit different. Yes, you get to pick whatever races or factions, as it were, you know. I say the factions would probably be Federation, Klingon, Romulan, or 23rd Century Federation. Now, here's the thing. The game itself is very unique. I saw some flaws and saw some good and bad things of it, you know. And I'll tell you this. I actually enjoyed it. Yes, I've been playing for about a week or so, so I can't say in a whole from beginning to end I've discovered every little aspect of this game. But I can tell that I really like this, because yes, I'm into Star Trek, also Star Wars and other sci-fi franchises, but I know the lore, I know the history and everything, I know way too much about it, even the production side. I enjoy it no matter what. But is this good for a fan? Yes, I think so. But for first-time users of this game, I know you're going to say, well, I've seen a lot of these type of games. I've seen photos of it. Is it really as fun as it say, or is it really just very boring? Because some of the videos I saw, the people just mine the same shit over and over. Well, you can do that if you want, if you're trying to mine to get enough currency of any kind to basically buy whatever you want. Yes, you can do that. There's some that just chat in there, and others go only for space battles, or they go into physical combat, you know, down on the character level, you know. Or they just want to make a badass, you know, armada, as it were. But for a first-time player, I thought that the whole entire 23rd century area was excellent for a beginner area. Because, yes, it was small. It was self-contained. But there was some lacking to it. Although, I know what it was for. it was meant for the fans, and it was meant as missions and whatever. And yes, allowed you to start off with that and go on with the storyline as if you're when you started the 23rd century. But I thought this was actually really good for somebody just learning, because you're not bogged down with a lot of people coming and going of different people and a lot of chatter on the chat box. But he had was a very intriguing story with it. I think it could have been better, but I actually loved the story of how it was, even though it was very short. But I want something more onto it. But yeah, once you get out of that, do the final mission, yes, you're thrown in the 25th century and there's a whole mess more stuff. But I like the 23rd because, like I said, for a beginner, when you're first starting, it teaches you the ropes. It doesn't, like, ban you or yell and scream. Sometimes you make mistakes, it tells you, but it'll just keep on doing it as, you know, but you don't lose, more or less. Even if your ship blows up, so what? You respond, and you start over the mission. You try another way of doing it. You figure things out. You notice within the first 100 deaths that you have, you find out what you've done wrong and what not to do and what to do next time, what to do better. And you end up growing as a person. I actually do like this aspect. It has a good storylines, especially if you're a Star Trek fan. Yeah, it's pretty good. I liked it because of the 23rd century section. It showed a lot of aspects of, like, scenes. I mean, the part where I got to go into Kirk's quarters, I'm surprised of how much detail they put into it. Because I'm a fan of Star Trek, even back to the original series, even back to The Cage with Christopher Pike. Yes, Kirk never went with green women. Not exactly. There was one green woman, but during Kirk's time, she was a prisoner. Yeah, that was a different thing. But if you're talking about the dancer, that was Pike, you know, the Orion slave girl, when they first introduced him. But enough of that. So, it is very interesting that they paid so much detail into just the aspects of a single room from a TV show from 1966 to 69 of when it was aired in America, its original air dates. You know, that much detail into a single room, and also the detail of the costumes of the characters. I thought that was good. They actually did that. Their research. It was excellent. I think it should have been a little bit more, but I still liked it the way it was. The characters looked very well done, including the Yeoman. Yes, Yeoman Rand, my favorite character. She's one of my favorites. And yes, she had very little lines, but she was one of my favorites. Second favorite. He died really early within the series. The only Irishman, the true Irishman, you know. I liked him. Well, anyways, it was actually quite fun and quite interesting. Okay, one of the missions, you're on the planet. Remember, well, planetoid or asteroid, whatever it is. I forgot what they were. It's the same place where, you know, Kirk went to, and there's these giant people, and they're throwing these giant spears. They're very primitive. They did a really good job of making them exactly how they looked back in the 60s. You know, the original design. I mean, it was kind of hokey, but even the spears, I mean, it was in the same look. It was actually quite refreshing and entertaining, plus it just, you want to get carried away, and even though it looked kind of hokey, but you like went with it. It's like, yay, I like this camp hokiness. I like that. It was fun. I enjoyed that. I'm gonna like to see a little bit more play on this, but it was actually quite enjoyable. And to in one area of this, they're like saying, like my character was saying about how huge was Nacelle Pod was. You know, it's like huge. Like talking about this, like, and she runs up and scanning rocks. These of pile of rocks. I'm like, no, that's not the Nacelle Pod. And down the little path, that's the effing Nacelle Pod, you dumbass. Of the shuttlecraft. You see part of the Nacelle Pod from the bottom of the shuttlecraft. And you find other parts until you see the wreckage or whatever. Alright. Until I start wandering around, and then I notice the map. You know, in the corner, I actually was able to get the whole entire map. I didn't realize pressing M at the time, because I really didn't go through the buttons. This is one of the flaws I do things is I usually fumble around just so I can know how to navigate, use my character. Then later on, I do is check with the short keys to find out, you know, which ones do what and stuff. You know, I'll just sit there just to hit each one just so, okay, I know what opens up what and just do this repetition and memorize. Till when I got the map of the area, I've noticed, oh shit, that's what they were talking about. Not the fucking rocks down there, but the Nacelle Pod that's way up there. But when you look, you know, you're on the ground, I don't see shit. Till you look at the map that's, you know, above you. Then you goes, oh yeah, that's right, because I didn't realize it until the section where you're running, and it's the back end of a starship. I'm thinking a Constitution ship, or just the same type of cruiser like I had, but it crashed. You go through the shuttle bay, you know. Well, it's most likely a smaller ship, you know. But still a cruiser. So, and then when you got to see the map, and like, oh yeah, then I know what they were talking about. But it doesn't punish you for, like, making mistakes. That's what I liked about the game. It didn't punish you saying, oh no, you made a mistake. Except for the part where you had to go on the Enterprise and disable these bombs. But you had was these different areas, but you didn't know. And so, no, not that one, you know, Scotty would say, not that one, you know. And then, but it did not, well, boom, you know, you had a time limit. I thought these missions in the 23rd century was very good for you to get started and to learn and to accept failure, to accept it. Yes, it's going to happen. You're going to make mistakes. But at least it doesn't punish you severely or anything. Like, you know, but it allows you to learn without ridicule. That's what I liked. I thought, yeah. And then, here's my problems with the game. I'm going to tell you some of the problems. I wish it did had was a first person view. I really did. Because I have a little bit of problem of this perspective. You know, yes, it's a floating cam. I like looking at my character. Yes, I usually like is a floating cam right behind the character, and as I'm running and I move the character, I'm used to fighting that way with a lot of RPGs, such as like the Dot Hack series. But with the Dot Hack series, you can also switch to first-person shoot. Yeah, first-person mode, which I actually like. But I wish it did have that. No, they had was an option where you press it and you're like in aiming mode more or less, but your moving of the camera is like it's fixed, but it or whatever, but you move it, it's because you're moving the cursor and the cursor is on the screen where it's like your target little thing, a little red thing. to aim and shoot and stuff. And it gives you bonuses of hitting, more likely to hit something, someone, do more damage and stuff. That I do like. But couldn't you also have done was a first-person view? And or just have it as a first-person view of doing that and rotating, But it might have been a little too busy. I don't know if it would have worked too well. But I think you should have been at least tried. Should have put it in to allow, an option for people. That's one of the problems. Another problem, it definitely can be fixed, but is it really a huge problem? The problem I've seen was when characters were supposed to sit down in chairs, they went all the way through and hitting the ground. There was a few missions that were like that. I haven't played a lot, but it's mainly the ones that were done by the fans that created their own missions, in the Foundry. And, I saw things like that. It was a little bit of a problem, but not too bad. So, I actually think, all in all, the game is good. Is it for everyone? No. Is it the greatest game in the world? No, it isn't. Is it a Star Trek game? Yes. It definitely does feel like a Star Trek game should. Yes, there's different types of Star Trek games, but this is the type where it seems more like melding two different types, or what they did on the PlayStation 2. That was done very well. Which is that you combine is an RPG story-driven game, and you have is your three-dimensional characters. You get to move your characters around. And you have away missions. I like that. Plus, it had was the space battles, but yes, you're not actually inside the ship. You see it from outside, but it feels more like the Star Trek games that were for the computer. The space simulator games where you flew around and stuff and attacked the ships, but also to be online and multiplayered, which I thought was very good. It was about time they've done something like this, or at least tried, and this one succeeded. And I think that if they continue on with this and expanding, the in-game lore, plus adding more content from the original series and the Next Generation, Deep Space Nine, Voyager, all the other ones, even the new Star Trek TV show, put that in. I like that. But I also want to see is like the other YouTube channels that did, the fan base stuff and like Star Trek Phase 2, where they did was actual scripts from, it was meant to be Star Trek 2, not the movie Star Trek 2, no, the TV production of Star Trek 2, the continuing voyages, or whatever it was, basically Phase 2. Anyways, I think they should do is translate that into a script for in this game, within the Foundry, because I did play one of the episodes from Star Trek Continues. From the YouTube channel, they did something over here, and I got to play was episode 2. I didn't find episode 1, but episode 2. Actually, I enjoyed it. I want to do is play it again. Go through it a little bit better next time, see what I can find, See what I missed. Just see how the aspect is. It's actually quite interesting. It's a fun playthrough. I liked it. So far, I have not really high expectation for it, but I have a lot of hope for it. And I actually enjoy the game. To me, it's fun. Of course, I'm into it. If you're into games like this, I think you should give it at least a try. Even if you're not a fan of Star Trek, so what? Go along with it. Just play along. Just think of it as any other, you know, space opera. Play it the way you want. For me, I'm playing a female character. She's 6'4". Her name is Malia Kulani Myers. And yes, she's a red shirt. She is of the 23rd century. Yeah, now she's in the 25th. I guess that's what it is now. With an old ship. And I'm continuing on with her storyline. I'm going to do some... I'm going to try to do playthroughs and stuff. Just me flying around and stuff, doing whatever. Just random shit, you know? I just want to show off these things, you know? But I want to keep her all within the 23rd century of look, you know? But I want to give her upgraded weapons, maybe. You know? Yeah. I'll see. But I'm thinking of doing is to keep role-playing her as the way she is. In the beginning, I liked the aspect where you can also do is not just edit the character. I love editing characters in the beginning the way you want them. Although it was very limited, but it was actually quite good for what it was. It wasn't too limiting. And it didn't give you way too many choices where it becomes nauseating. But it gave you enough freedom to get to where you want. Or at least be at least happy with it. And not too complex where it becomes too hard to get the character the way you want it with. So, you know, making it all fucked up or something, you know. But yeah, I like the character creation part. Most people are going to complain about the economic system, but in this world, in reality, we don't have one currency, folks. We have multiple currencies. And games, they're not meant to be free. Well, I do enjoy free games, but I think supporting the devs does help. Because you're supporting a franchise, a game that you like. You want it to continue existing online. So I suggest doing that. But I like the aspect where free-to-play games, like this one, where it doesn't say that, oh, you have to pay to even continue playing. You can only go so far, but if you want to continue, you have to give us this much money. I don't like that. But it gave you options saying, hey, here's these packs, here's these ships, here's certain things that you might want, might you'll like and stuff, that you have bonuses and whatever. That's going to cost you some money. That I do like. That gives people an option that want to get all these items. That, I think, is a good model. Not the greatest model, but a very good model for a free-to-play game to make money. It does work. But doesn't force it down your throat like, you gotta, you know, you gotta pay. You know, I've really enjoyed the way it is. Another thing I've noticed when I was in the 5th century, I think that's what it is now, where everyone is now, I go around and I've noticed how there's different types of characters. Yeah, I already knew there would be. And I've noticed one guy I saw that was completely bored and no one paid any attention. No one said shit. And I thought, wow, he looks cool. Amazing, but cool. I went up to him just to look at his character. My character's staring at him, basically checking him out and seeing how good he's designed and stuff. I thought, wow, that is great. That's neat looking, you know? And then later on, I found this other character. She was dancing on tabletops, and she's a Rear Admiral. I looked at it. She was like the Borg. He, in his bio, there's nothing. And most people, I've noticed nothing. People just nothing. But this Rear Admiral, I already put a storyline, you know, kind of a basis, but I'm going to continue and edit it and make it better for Malia. This Rear Admiral, I saw her. She's dancing on a table. She can do that. I thought, that's pretty cool. You can do this. But do I really want to? Not really, but I thought that was kind of interesting and cool to add on. She's a Rear Admiral, by the way. But anyways, she was an ambassador as well or something, you know, her diplomatic rank. Well, anyways, I looked at it. She has this excellent bio that goes back before her character went into Starfleet or any of this shit. So it tells, like, her whole background story, how she started and what she's done. And it's like, that is so awesome. And someone put into so much detail and care into that. I'm thinking, great, there's someone actually role-playing and having an excellent story for a character. I love that. I spent time just reading her bio. I'm like, wow. That I like to see more people do. Take your time and create a great bio for your character. Give your character life. Don't just have it on just some dead shell. You know? I know some people just prefer making their character look cool, but they really want to do is the space battles. Yeah, I can see that. And some just want to do is chat with others, you know, have fun, you know. I've seen people just talk and walk around, and they're not doing anything. They just have cool-looking characters. I think it's because they've already done everything, and there's nothing new for them yet because they went through everything. For me, I went through all the missions for Agents of Yesterday, or is it Yesteryear or something like that? Agents of Yesteryear. Yeah, the 23rd Century section. I started my character there, did all through that, went through it so fast. I enjoyed the area, but I wish I could go back. That's one of the problems I think it has. But I also want to see more added onto it. But I like it the way it was, too. But I want it more, and I want it to at least be able to go back. But you can redo the missions. You can do the missions and things, but can you go back to there? No. But I wish you could. A lot of us do. Because it's kind of cool. It's very detailed on exactly how the show was. A show that was from 66 to 69. Those 3 years. How cool. Even the hokiest parts, you know, how, you know. But it was awesome to see how much care and detail they'd done to it. But I liked it. Even just the way it was. But I wish that they had was a disclaimer, at least within the last episode, within that, you know, last mission, saying if you complete this, you will be with the rest of the game, but you can never, ever get back here. Never. You can redo the missions, but you can't ever go back. It's like, oh, no, no, no. But, you know. Oh, well, at least there's more stuff outwards I can continue on, and that's what I'm going to do, and I'm going to end up starting other characters later on and play different playthroughs, because I want to do is a Romulan playthrough, also one for the Klingon Empire, and probably one for the Federation of, I guess, in the 24th, 25th century period. Eh. Yeah. Well, I have my 23rd century character, so I'll have her. I might actually do is another 23rd century and just leave it in the 23rd. Just get the character all badass, have fly around just doing the same missions except for the last one. Never going to do the last one. Never! just so I could just have it stayed there and helping the noobs out or whatever. Oh, well. I think it's okay. But it seemed like it was kind of small, but then again, I liked it. It was very intimate, and it was very a unique experience. It was very good for a first-time player of it. But when you first play, you think, is this all there is? But then but if I started with how everybody is, I probably would have gotten lost. It's like, okay, there's a lot of things, a lot of people, a lot of missions. I feel like I have a lot to overcome. But starting in the 23rd, even though it was small and then very intimate, it allowed me to make mistakes where I didn't feel pressure. Plus, I was able to learn from these mistakes and learn the game, learn all the mechanics, even with space flight. But I like to say to people in that area, learn to fly around. Just even if you mess up, just do the mission over and over again. So you take time and learn the aspects of combat. Even though it's simple, you need the skills on this to play. The same thing with combat within, you know, moving your character. Just take your time of learning how to move your character, different aspects, how to do it. For me, I died a lot with my character because instead of just using my phaser and this phaser rifle, I decided to do was go Shatner on their asses, you know, running up, punching. I like to see her, you know, fucking clocking people, doing kicks and spins and shit like that. I like that. That was very fun. Well, till next time, ciao.